We're coming over.
Do it.
We're going live.
Yes.
We're doing it live. And transition.
Not an escapist room if we're not fixing things live.
We got to fix things live, Nick, because I didn't have the thing. Hey, everybody. Welcome to the thing where we stream. Oh, everything broke. Hold on.
It's because your pot's in the way.
It's because of my pot. My pots are. I had to add more pots. You see, that was really important. I can put it. Yeah, because this is stream number 9. Here, we can put it a little more behind the pot, there. But now the pot's got to go in front. What jar is that? That's important. Okay, that's this.
You don't have them all labeled.
Yeah, I just need to find
top out. Right 9th jar.
That is jar 3-2.
Well,
there we go. Now it's behind the jar.
Setting that up. Welcome back, everybody.
Hi, everybody. You did it. You came back. Okay, so the first thing you're going to notice, for those of you who are just joining us, one, welcome. Two, this is Elden Ring Challenge Runs, in which I find new and interesting ways to play Elden Ring. This is play as a warrior jar. Here is my warrior jar. I put some pants on. I feel like they are still within the jar realm. Like, I still look like a jar, so I'm going to be okay with it, but I just wanted a little extra protection. And we might need to turn you down a little bit. There we go. You might notice that I am in a different location because I spent a good portion of the afternoon warming up, which is not what I normally do with Elden Ring, but we've been having some Malekith issues. I am also having some wild internet surges. So if frames started dropping, I do apologize. I don't know if there's anything I can do about it at the moment.
Shows excellent condition on YouTube, so we're doing okay.
Great. So,
welcome to SVS Guru, starting us off right away with yes. You may have noticed, and I'm sure Jack is very excited about it. Our next funding goal is up to film Adventures Nigh Season 3 on location in Milwaukee.
Oh,
with the whole team there.
Oh boy. It's crazy. It's like, you know, because we've joked about, like, all getting together and playing before, but we haven't, like, now it might actually happen, and it's so very exciting.
This will happen.
You know, I'm still trying to be patient and be, like, cautious, because, like, I really want it to happen, but I understand the difficulties.
You guys are starting filming on my actual birthday.
What?
Yeah, so I'm going to come out there and then we're going to go party that night.
I am old, so I don't party as hard, but absolutely, we'll do something. We'll do something.
All right, so SVS Guru 2025 Euro says, Nick, when you conquered the throne of the escapist, did you ever imagine that you'd appear on videos and streams yourself? Fuck no.
Yeah, Jack, you were not.
Jack was there. Yeah, Jack was there when we wanted to do the escapist show, and just convincing me to get on camera was like pulling my hair out. Because I think the initial pitch was not having me on camera with you.
For the escapist show.
Yeah.
Oh right.
Either it was, but you also like kept making fun of me because I had the camera at an angle because I was too afraid to look into it.
We had some, you know, you are used to being a behind the scenes person, and so yeah, there was some convincing as far as you and being on camera was concerned.
Storm Templar subscribe to tier 1, and I am going to read out their message for power, even though they were mean to me. I'm a nice person. They've subscribed for 42 months on a 37 month streak. I feel like that's as long as you've been here now. So
I've been here for about that long. Yeah.
Jack, I remember that my grandmother's maiden name was Packer. So do you have and relatives from the Seattle area? If so, we might be distant cousins.
No one that I know of who's from there. But that would be from my dad's side that I don't know as well. I do not know my father's side as well as my mother's side. My parents are divorced, as are most parents nowadays, let's be honest. And so that's nothing necessarily special, but so I grew up mostly with my mom's side. So I don't know that side of the family very well. We could be distant relatives.
Technically, we're all distant relatives.
So technically,
especially
that's
in Marty's world,
right? I know, like there's like some dubiousness behind the like, you know, 23andMe hereditary nonsense. as far as like doing it yourself is like giving a company access to your DNA.
Yeah.
But like, there is a part of me that definitely like wants to, for curiosity's sake.
Have you ever like just Googled your name to see what comes up?
Just Googled your name.
Yeah, like Google Jack Packard to see how many other people are called Jack Packard.
Oh, sure. Like, you know, I definitely, like, I used to do that back in the day. You know, now me comes up. But there is, what I discovered, yeah. Was that there it was an old radio detective show starring Detective Jack Packard, which is badass.
I have a Google alert for my name just to make sure that, you know, nobody's stalking me or saying weird shit about me.
All right.
And last year I got a Google alert for a Nick Calandra was shot dead by police. And I was like, oh.
Oh.
It's like, great.
That's terrifying.
Yeah. Because it popped up on my phone. I was like, wait a second.
And then you're just like, that's wait, my name. Am I dead?
Yeah. Did I die?
Did I die?
What'd I do?
All right, so by the way, for anyone who is curious, which hopefully is all of you, the reason we are here is, one, because I was warming up. So, like, I did take out some lower-level boss. Yeah, I know I used a sword so key. I took out some lower-level bosses, you know, like, I've been warming up. But then I also realized that we have been running this... We've been running Flame of the Red Mains, and the spectral tier that causes people's stance to break more often, right?
Mm-hmm.
So we've been getting the critical hits, and here in the castle is a talisman that means you do harder critical hits. I gotta find it. I forget where it is. It's around here somewhere.
Oh, you're looking for that. Fat Highlander 23, member for 22 months in early access. Go, Jack. Looking for that Malodeth,
yes. Yeah, this is it. This is the last chance to kill Malekith. I'm calling it because I'm done, baby. I am done with Malekith. So, actually, we're kind of there now. Let's see if we can find another boss just to warm up with.
Heavy Rivera donates $5, says tip the jar, wanted to show some support, y'all are awesome, go Jack.
Oh yeah, thank you.
And SES Guru 2000 another $5 says, Jack, after watching the side quest video, I realized that often when someone does a German accent, the resulting character sounds like a gay German.
Oh. you know why? Because it's silly. Like that's a very silly accent. You know, my Hansel Fjock. If you do German, you either go down and you go angry, and you go German and down and angry, or you go kind of bouncy. And, you know, like, those are, like, the comic extremes. And I went bouncy that day for Hansel Fjock. But you can't go, you know, just down and German and kurt fuck it like a sucker fuck it. You know, that kind of stuff.
Beastmarsh donates $5, says, here's to getting the crew together and for Jack beating Malekith.
Ooh, baby. Get it. Y'all, like, it's very exciting. Like, we've been talking behind the scenes a little bit now. Oh, wait, hold on. Let's change our equipment. Okay, so we are going...
Oh, by the way.
Here we go. This guy.
So you're going to have to check your Slack real quick, Jack.
Oh.
We're not revealing it to the public yet. I'm just showing it to you so that you can say that you've seen it on stream and make the public jealous.
Oh, okay.
Because we're putting together a piece of merch, but they can't know what it is yet.
Okay, hold on. I'm looking at Slack on my phone because I don't want to accidentally, like, screen share this. You know? What? What is that even? What is that?
I can't say.
First of all, I'm crazy excited. Secondly, I should probably know what this is.
it's Yahtzee's the leaker. Yahtzee and Marty, the two leakers of the escapists for anything that's interesting.
That's beautiful. That's exciting. Oh, you know, I didn't wear. I
think if you zoom in on it, you'll be able to tell what it is.
I don't necessarily know what it is, but that's really exciting. I did finally the other day. I broke down and purchased a Black Eyed Susan's T-shirt because you keep forgetting to send me one.
I told you guys to buy an invoice.
And so I just bought one, and I'm very excited about my Black Eyed Susan's T-shirt.
Is it already there?
Yeah. Yeah, it's pretty.
I've never seen, like, I know KZ and Amy and all invoiced merch, and I've never seen them wear it on stream.
You know, you forget. Okay.
Novelty condoms. No, it's definitely not that.
Ew, because what would they be flavored like? Ew.
Jeremy Good Sex branded condoms. It just makes a noise when you put it on.
Okay, so here's going to be Malekith attempt number one. So over in Redmayne Castle, we got the dagger talisman, which enhances critical hits. We have the jump enhancement. We got a boost to our strength and to our dexterity. I put some pants on. We got Flame of the Redmaynes.
I can't stop laughing about their god making that kind of noise.
And like the thing is, it only makes that noise when you unroll it, and so basically, it stops you from ever having sex. Because you're like, "Don't worry, baby, I got protection." And they go, "No, I'm okay.
I don't want that sound."
No, thank you. All right, here we go. Here we go.
God. All right. Malekith.
Not doing great already.
Cabrera says, "Hey, you know, get the escapist team, sign a piece of Avengers 9 merch, and send it to me. I'll pay." Yeah, we're working on stuff for things like that. So just stay tuned. We gotta work with the new parent company. I think can help out with merch more than our previous parent company, because our previous parent company did nothing to help with us. So.
The issue, of course, with us all signing stuff is the issue that we're dealing with you know, recording ourselves live, which is we all live on different sides of the planet.
Yeah, if we're gonna sign stuff, it'll be when we get this funding goal sorted out.
Oh, actually,
because I can't send this stuff everywhere. So I'll just get I'll get boxes of postcards and all that kind of
stuff. Could you imagine how expensive? Like, so let's say like you want a T-shirt signed, right? Mm-hmm. Like you send it there, you send it across the globe.
It's like $300 just to get a T-shirt signed. Just one.
Just in shipping to get one T-shirt signed. That is insanity.
Yeah, we for the Kickstarter. When we did the documentaries, we got all the like documentary covers signed, but so we basically had to create all the physical rewards before we even went to any of the shoots and bring them with us so that we could sign them while we were there filming. Logistics nightmare, but we got it done.
I believe it. All right. That's not bad damage at all.
FBS Guru 2000 donates 2 years again, says Adventures Nigh Plushies win. It's on my list of merch items. We actually have a sponsor meeting tomorrow for a company called Cuddly. And they make like customized like hoodie blankets.
Ooh.
And we're gonna talk to them about maybe doing like a product partnership to get like Adventures Nigh or ZP themed stuff like that.
I like it. I like it.
Lots of ideas going on right now. It's a fun time being bought by a new company. Can be fun if you don't have to lay everybody off. teacher card. And it's $5. Says the good thing about being the forever DM is using your residence for the games. Good luck meeting your goal. Jack's residence just happens to work out because he's like in the center of the country, so it's easiest for everybody from the East and West Coast to get there.
Yeah, I am...
Plus me, I'm south of him, so...
Like, I am the most disappointed by us filming live because I, of course, don't get to go on a fun trip anywhere. And, you know, like, I think all the players are going to end up being disappointed because it's like, oh, Milwaukee.
Yeah.
You know, which I love, which is, like, the city that I choose to live in. But it's not necessarily, you know, like, if we were going to go to, say, like, Australia, everyone would be super excited.
Yeah.
I could have shot it at my house in Kansas City, which is just as exciting as Milwaukee. More? Less? I don't know. This is looking good, Jack.
I am feeling very happy about this. Flame of the Red Mains is a ridiculous Ash of War. Oh no, oh no. Bad idea. No. Move.
First time chat. It says, come to Australia. Funnily enough, our new parent company is based out of Australia.
Ah. I do want to come to Australia. We'll work on that for next time.
Jack, you were so close.
That was the closest I've gotten. No, and I just got, I got trapped. I got trapped and then I drank the wrong flask. I drank my empty blue flask. I'm really happy with this combination, this break stance, do extra critical damage. This is a good combination. I'm feeling very confident about me beating Malekith. Cut to me not beating Malekith by the end of the stream. But yeah, maybe next time we do an in-person thing, we'll get to do it at a fancier location. But Milwaukee, it might not be the fanciest, but you know what it is? Pretty darn cheap.
Yep. Anywhere in the Midwest. I love doing stuff in the Midwest because it's always cheaper.
Yes.
PAX Australia next year. Yeah, the plan is to finally get us back out into the world and traveling and doing trips because we want to film stuff in person. We just had no support to do it, and this company specifically wants us to do it, so it's good.
Yeah!
We're working with a company now that actually knows what media is.
What? Media? I've heard so much about this.
Me too. I mean, some days I still don't know what I'm doing. But... if you're in the chat, Cat312, welcome to Patreon. Thanks for your support. We are less than 50 patrons to go until Jack and Yahtzee also get to play Pulsar Last Colony together. So if you're not on Patreon, help us get to that goal and sign up. We want to be fully supported by subscriptions and super chats and all that so that we don't rely on a parent company, which is how they want it too, so they can just invest in us and we can just grow. Peace March. Jack, how do I cheese the Elden Beast?
How do you cheese the Elden Beast? The Elden Beast has ridiculously small poise. Like, just poise break. See Flame of the Red Mains? That's how you cheese Elden Beast. Ridiculously small poise.
Mirali G, it's probably the video lagging. Jack's having some internet troubles.
We are dropping frames. We are dropping frames all over the place. It could be an internet thing, could be an OBS thing, could
he
be.
He just steamrolled you there.
Yeah, I made a mistake, and that's okay because we're still learning. We're still getting into that groove. I brought out my boys a little too early. So Elden Beast, poise break, and I don't know, everyone says they have a hard time with Elden Stars. I've never had a hard time with it. Elden Beast is really easy to read, so, you know.
A SVS Guru 2000, known as 5 euros, says, how many companies has the Escapist been sold to so far? Seems kind of a volatile situation. Any plan B in case the big boss decides to end it all? They started with Defy, and then we're sold to Themis Media, and then to Enthusiast Gaming, and then now Gamers. We don't really, plan B would be, you know, hopefully, like, you know, Yavi and I could purchase the site before it was ever shut down. But, like, honest to God, like, we're in a very good position right now. Sustained growth year over year because of the streaming and the super chats and all your subscription money. So we are ahead of the game. I mean, aside from, like, other independent outlets that are specifically only fan-funded, as far as a corporate outlet, we are ahead of the game for pretty much everybody else in how we run things these days.
Stop it.
And the best of both worlds is having corporate backing and being self-sufficient. And that's what we're trying to get to. So when you have corporate backing, you have somebody that's behind you investing in what you're doing to help you grow. And then when you're fan-funded in conjunction with that, then you have a sustainable model to build from.
Fuck. Can you go fuck off for a second, Malekith? If you could just fuck off for, like, 5 seconds, that would make me just so fucking happy. I just need 5 fucking seconds, Malekith. 5 gosh darn seconds. Nope, 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 nope. 5 fucking seconds in the entirety of the world.
Nope, your health bar. Maybe you should just take off all your armor.
Huh?
Oh, yeah, you can't because you're a jar.
I can't because I'm a jar. And, like, you know, my armor is helping. I am now completely out of healing flasks from Malekith's, like, first attacks. Second phase, first attacks. Get him, Jars, get him! And I think I'm almost out of blue.
Yes, the running Jars are back. I love it.
I love the running Jars. They are adorable.
Man, I remember that spinning move. That messed me up so many times.
Oh, he's the worst.
Yes, yeah, he really is. He's the Toby of the video game.
Oh, fuck.
Hey, you're getting closer and closer.
Yeah, we're getting there. We're getting there.
You're getting a lot closer than you were last stream.
Oh, I'm getting significantly closer than I was last stream, yes. I feel like I need to concentrate a little bit more on getting a bleed proc in the first phase. That way that'll kind of, like, save some of my blue for the second phase. And then I can just spam flame, 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 flame in the second phase. But we will see. Hold on for a second. Sorry, everybody. Click, click. Sorry, everybody. I'm having a little trouble seeing chats. Not like I can read while I'm...
Wardens.
Okay, here we go. Ooh, all right.
I didn't know they had a new Red Ranger. I haven't been able to watch any of the preseason games. Because for some reason, they weren't on my Hulu. I've been playing Pure Pyro S. I've been playing a lot of Phasmophobia. I one of my buddies just got a gaming PC, and I've been trying to get him into new gaming experiences that he isn't used to, because, like, he's the kind of guy that would only play Call of Duty or Fortnite or any of that stuff. I have gotten him completely addicted to Phasmophobia, because his whole thing was he didn't like being scared, and now he loves being scared. So we've been playing that pretty much every night lately.
Very nice.
I truly, truly, truly believe Yahtzee is actually really going to love that game.
Everything I've heard about it sounds fantastic. It's just, oh, wow.
Yeah, I mean, I think even you might like it.
Yeah, I've heard nothing but good things. I don't like that it's, you know, dependent on multiplayer.
It works because everybody has a role to play.
Okay.
So, like, you're going to have somebody with a flashlight to basically guide you forward. You have somebody staying in the truck to basically keep an eye on activity levels and watch cameras for signs of the ghost. You have... you know, somebody that plays kind of like the defender role, and you know, the whole point is like hunting down the ghost and like basically.
I understand that. What my concern is with the multiplayer only is finding a group.
Oh.
You know, like
everybody on Escapist likes the game, so.
A multiplayer game like Rocket League is real easy just to jump into an online match, and anyone can, you know, like, oh, everyone kind of knows what they're doing, and an online match is an online match. Here it sounds like you need a communicative group sort of atmosphere.
Yes, you absolutely do.
And that's where, like, a multiplayer only can turn bad real fast.
Yeah. I would never play Phasmophobia with randoms because they would just scare me the entire time.
Sure.
Because my friends already do that, so. Foxes and Cats donates £4.49, says, will you also be recording Breakout live in person when you're all together doing Adventures Nigh? Yeah, we could. Marty will be there too, so. I don't know if we'll be able to do it live. It's possible. Yeah, just have to make sure that we have the right equipment to hook up all of our cameras to record it live.
Oh, come on. I definitely rolled out of that.
Andy Anako, and $5 says, any thoughts to getting the Adventures Nigh crew on a stream to play Baldur's Gate 3 as their characters when it comes out? Yeah. I'm sure. I don't know if they would like it, but can always try.
Classic.
Andrew Whitewinner asks, is Phasmophobia the one game you don't try to team kill? Not accusing. You know how you do on the streams. So, we were playing yesterday with my friends, and there's a summoning circle, and we set the summoning circle off, and you can only hide two people in a closet at a time, where the ghost will find you if there's a third person in there. So I immediately booked it up to the closet before they even finished the summoning circle, like kind of quietly, because I was like, no, fuck that. And one of my buddies tried to get into the closet as he was being hunted by the ghost, and I shut the door in his face because I was too scared, and he died.
Nah.
So I don't know if that's a team kill. But
that's 100% team kill. Yeah.
Well, I didn't do the killing. I didn't want him to give me away. So
you facilitated in the killing.
I made a tactical choice
in killing your teammate. Yeah, that's still a team kill.
Yes. Is Phasmophobia any good if you don't play in VR? I'm too afraid to play that game in VR. That game is terrifying. We're streaming it on the 22nd with Yahtzee, and I fully expect to hear Yahtzee scream like a little girl. Because I scream like a little girl when I play it. Galvanite Tech says, ah yes, the better you than me strategy. Absolutely. It was my closet. He wanted to stay alive. He should have found another closet.
It was my closet.
What I'm hearing is, don't be a D&D party with me. Someday I'll find time to be on Adventures Nigh. What do you mean? Amy was the one that killed me all the time in Divinity. I don't know what you're talking about.
Fucking fuck Malekith. Fucking fuck. I hate you so much.
Everybody's making coming out of the closet jokes. Nope, I'm happily staying in. There's ghosts outside.
The ghosts of girls?
Half the time in Phasmophobia, yeah. They sing to you.
Ooh.
I'm singing Ring Around the Rosie, and I'm like, I don't want to ring around the Rosie. They don't choke you in a good way.
Oh my, okay, now. We're going to weird places now.
Well, that's how they kill you every time in the game. You see their hands come around your throat and they choke you to death. No, I didn't kill Amy in Halo and Gears. Amy got herself killed in Gears. Because she was just bad timing. In Halo, she just made bad decisions listening to me and drove her tank into a hole. That's her fault.
She drove her tank into a hole. That's,
She's known me since 2017, 2018. She should know better that when tell her to do something in a game is probably not a good choice.
Stop driving your tank into a hole, you know what I'm saying?
That's still one of the funniest things that's ever happened on the streams.
Hole tank?
I literally, like, she was in a tank, and she's like, where do we go next? I was like, well, to go forward, you gotta go this way to go forward.
Yeah.
And she's like, are you sure? I was like, yeah. And then she just drove her tank into a bottomless pit.
No, you know what? I don't think Malekith is extra squirrely today. Like, this is how Malekith always is for me. Yeah. Everyone has that boss that, like, is murder for them, and other people are like, nah, he's great. And for me, it's Malekith. Malekith is always a pain in my ass. And then for these challenge runs, even more so, because, you know, I can't do it how I want to do it.
Max KO donates $5, says another tip for the live meet. Love all the content you guys make. Well, thank you.
Oh, crap.
And Fart asks, which Halo is that? It was Halo 2. But I also made her do it in Halo 3. And Halo 4 and 5 don't really have good sandboxes, so I couldn't really mess with her too much in those games. No speakeasy. KC shot me in the back.
Fucking
and I know KC's in chat. So he can confirm that he maliciously shot me in the back in Siege. And Snake in the Garden wants to know, what role would you play in D&D? An attack role like Amy, or a bar that runs away into support like Yachts? Whenever I've played D&D, I'm usually witty and sarcastic, but I also am, I can be character likes to be violent. Ooh, those are the new jerseys for the Red Wings. Those look like throwback. I don't like that. Gross. Oh, okay, KC's victim blaming me. Oh, where'd Jack go? Jack just disappeared.
What?
Oh, you're still there.
I just needed a moment to scream to myself.
You got a pillow over there?
No, that's the bad part. I just fucking Malekith, man. Fucking Malekith. Oh, this guy. I know, like, for his, like, when he puts his sword in the ground and the spinny blades come out, you're supposed to get behind him, but I always forget when he does that. He does his, like, sword stab explosion into that, and so it's just a, oh, man, oh, ugh, yeah, ugh.
Yeah, the way I beat him was just staying on him at all times, like, never let up on him, because you can iframe through, like, everything, like, really close to him.
Oh yeah, and with as you see here, it takes just two like full Flame of the Red Mains to stance break him. So it's like pretty easy, or it's easy-ish. Yeah, at least, you know, to get through first phase here. But that second phase, I don't know, it freaks me out.
Yeah, he jumps around everywhere.
Right?
The only problem with him, like his design in this game, is like he's the only boss that really is that like agile in this game.
Right. And like he's jumping up on poles, he's doing all sorts of BS.
He's just like he doesn't feel like he fits.
Yeah. There I got really lucky that we were right near a stance break, and I was able to get it with just one.
Nice.
No, let me heal. No, that was so sweet. I just want to heal. You son of a bitch. That was the optimal run right there, where we got to second phrase on the precipice of a stance break. I was able to break his stance right away, get some big damage in, and really what I probably should have done is broken his stance, which would have let me call my jars to distract him. Because I've been saving my jars to distract him for second phase, and so I think we're going to try that. We are going to attempt that move if we can get the he's doing the slow, see, like it's different now, he's doing the slow walk up now.
See, I would feel bad for you if I hadn't spent 8 hours on mission in Sekiro. You're only at about 4 hours.
Right. No, I'm not like no, and you know, like I said, if we can't do it today, then it's SpongeBob Tarnish Pants, which is the next thing that I've been working towards.
SpongeBob Tarnish Pants?
SpongeBob Tarnish Pants. Which, if you know anything about SpongeBob, you know what SpongeBob's main weapon is.
Is a spatula in this game?
Bubbles.
Oh. That sounds awful.
Yes, it's not the best.
You should do a Souls challenge where you play a Souls game you've never played before.
I think I've played them all.
Or a Souls-like.
There we go. No, I'm good. You know, once we get, because the next big thing for the, at least for my Monday streams, is we're going to play the entirety of the Willow NES game.
Right.
Before Willow comes out. Do we know when that comes out? When does Willow come out on Disney Plus?
I think November.
Oh, okay. Well then actually that might happen sooner than later, with Mr. Malekith Pants here.
November 30th.
Oh, okay. Oh, then we got it. Yeah. So then, starting in November, we will start with Willow NES to be part of Willow Month. Official Willow Month here at the Escapist. It's happening.
We should do a challenge run on Bloodborne. That's what you should do next.
A challenge run on Bloodborne.
Yeah.
Okay. A little harder to roleplay in Bloodborne, but I'm with it. It's also just been a hot minute since I played Bloodborne, so I'm down.
Bloodborne's always a good choice.
Right?
Stone Templar highlights a message that says, "What is the best Souls like not made by FromSoft?" I was literally just thinking of this the other day. Shit. Oh, Neo. I'm playing that right now. It's not even. I don't think it's close anymore after having played it. I mean, the Surge. I would put Neo and then the Surge 2. Even though I haven't finished the Surge 2, but for the way they play.
Okay, here we go. Now we're going to call out my friends. Now my friends will distract him.
Could you play J-Mate's Adventure as my character in Bloodborne?
Yeah.
Grandma with a stick. FedEx, I hate you so much. So somebody sent me a package to my, I think my apartment, my old apartment.
To your old apartment?
Yes. But I don't know who sent me the package.
Okay.
And I guess I have to be there to receive it.
At your old apartment?
Yes. So I called FedEx, be like, hey, like, you're trying to deliver a package to me. I don't live there anymore. Can I change the address?
Yeah.
Well, they're like, you're going to have to contact whoever sent it to change the delivery address. I'm like, I don't know who sent it. Can you tell me? No. Okay. So now I got to go like drive like 25, 30 minutes to go pick up a package. I don't even know what I'm picking up. I don't even know if it's worth picking up.
No, 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 Malekith. No, Malekith! Oh, oh, wait, wait, wait. Wait, wait, wait. Do I get to do it?
Wow, what a sound that is.
Oh, I fucking hate Malekith so much.
That was sure a sound you just made. Somebody clip that.
Oh, fuck.
It, I think it took you... Do you want to know how many times it took you to do that?
I do. I do.
32 tries.
Oh, 32 tries. That makes sense.
Yeah, so I only have, like, I don't have... I can't see what Jack's doing on the game. Cause he's not streaming it to me.
Right.
So, like, I'm behind on the stream, obviously. So the only way I know you win is when you make weird sounds.
I am absolutely shocked. But I do think, like, what Nick was saying, and I think what a lot of chat was saying, was kind of, like, getting close to him. And, like, just figuring out those stupid patterns of, like, when he does his ground, you roll here, you get behind him when he does the rolly thing, get out my guys to distract him. It's all those, like, little things that you have to remember for every boss. It's a rhythm game. It's a puzzle game. I love this game, but fucking fuck Malekith so hard. I just hate Malekith so much. Oh, great.
All right, so... For the 32 tries, that means 32 new people join the Patreon, right?
Hey,
that's how that works. Every time you die, somebody has to join the Patreon. I think that sounds fair to me.
That's just fair.
Tubby 13, 13, 13.
Nice.
Member 20 months in bonus content. Says, what Elden Ring boss does Jack think would be improved with a Youper voice?
A Youper.
Youper? What the fuck is a Youper?
Someone from the UP, aka the Upper Peninsula.
Oh,
I've
never heard that, and I lived in Michigan.
Oh, okay. Well, Michigan and Wisconsin is weird. You know, obviously we have a Great Lake that surrounds the majority of the state, but there is a part of land that is attached to Wisconsin that is part of Michigan.
Yeah. Mm-hmm.
For those of you who do not know, and so like all of Michigan is on one side of the lake. All of Wisconsin is on one side of the lake. 95% of Michigan is on the other side of the lake. And then there's this little thing that's attached to Wisconsin and not attached to the rest of Michigan. That is Michigan. That is the Upper Peninsula. And it would be very similar to like a Fargo voice. You know, like, oh, how's it going there? Oh, yeah, there. We got lots of Schlitz and Pabst up here. That's what we do. So I think the character that could be the best with that voice is I mean, there's so many good ones. I could see like Gideon, the all-knowing, right? Being like, oh, we got lots of spells up here. Oh, yeah, there. What do you need to know? I got some books. We can sit down, have a paps, and read some books. He would be hilarious.
I think it'd be that guy that was standing on top of the rock in the opening area.
Standing on top of the rock.
You get the quest to go take his castle back.
Oh, Kenneth Hite?
Yeah, Kenneth Hite.
Oh, who wants to help Kenneth Hite, eh? Okay, no, here we go. My fishing shack, my ice fishing shack. Some no good Nick. He's been using it, drilling holes, and I can't fish in there. I don't want to say anything because, you know, I'm a nice guy over here, so I don't want to say too much. But if you could just help me get my shack back. yeah, that'd be great. That would be great.
Steelclad Gamer donated $32 Canadian for your 32 deaths.
I appreciate that. You know, it is what it is. It's real tricky sometimes. It's so funny. Like as a warm up, last night I got this. I got the SpongeBob Tarnished Pants idea. And so like as a warm up, last night I was testing to see if SpongeBob Tarnished Pants was a viable build. Basically. And I'm actually, now that I think about it, there is a better build. Oh no, there's not. Oh, you can't do that. Ooh, because my idea with SpongeBob Tarnished Pants was you can only use things that SpongeBob is known for using, and so like you know you can use your jellyfish as a summons because SpongeBob is big jellyfisher, right? SpongeBob blows bubbles, and so there is a bubble spell that you can get very early in the game without fighting anything. And then later, you can get, like, the giant spell hammer, which is, like, such a big cartoon thing, right? Of just, like, hitting people with a giant mallet. So I was like, oh, a SpongeBob build could be fun. So that's my plan for my next one. Is SpongeBob Tarnished Pants, which would be, you know, spell based, which would be range, which is something I'm very much looking forward to. Okay, so now we got to go fight Gideon, the all knowing there.
I almost want you to do that just so I can have Padmethon make the thumbnail art SpongeBob the Tarnished.
SpongeBob Tarnished Pants?
Yeah.
Oh, yeah. Yeah, I'm with you. I'm with you. Do an
I still want to see Bloodborne.
Here's the problem with Bloodborne is it's not.
There is no problem with Bloodborne.
Oh wait, you want to see me play Bloodborne? Because the other character that I've been working on is playing Bloodborne inside Elden Ring.
Whoa.
Which just gets boring after a little bit because you know, it's a lot of the same stuff. Let's see here.
Tom Templar says, how much money can I donate to Vito the SpongeBob idea? Join the Patreon.
To Vito the SpongeBob idea, you can join the Patreon.
If you are in chat, Nick pledged $2 to the Patreon. Not me, some other Nick. They're trying to steal my name, but they gave us money to steal my name.
So okay there.
Yeah, I am the only Nick in existence. It's fine.
The SpongeBob run is fun because like, one, the bubble spell is very powerful if you can get all the bubbles to hit. Getting all the bubbles to hit is very like I was able to beat Mordecai. Who's the God damn it.
I feel like that run would absolutely end when you get to the Godskin duo.
Oh well, you know I'd have my hammer. I'd have my hammer, and I'd have my bubbles, and I'm sure we can find some other things that would be SpongeBob adjacent, right? Some other things that, like, especially spells or weapons that could be, like, that we could skin as SpongeBob, you know? There's no net in the game, unfortunately.
There's got to be a spat. There's like a... Not a spatula, but there's definitely like a big rake you can get, right?
There's a big rake you can get. There's like a short sword that's very spatula-esque. You can, for Ash of War, you could do like the barbaric roar that you could call his laugh. Like, hey!
Maybe you should should do a Squidward run.
A flute only run?
Yeah.
Here's the thing. I've seen flute only runs. It's
pretty. Well, he doesn't use a flute. He uses a clarinet.
Well, you know what I mean.
No, they're two different instruments. That's right. What a sad state of affairs. I commend your spirit, but alas. Sub anniversary announcements. I read them out today. I think there's only one so far, right? Nils Enthusiast donates $2 as obligatory live stream donation for Live Adventures 9.
Hooray! We are into it. Yeah, deal with my jars, Gideon. Get out of my way, jars. Shit. Oh, you're out of juice, my friend.
That one spell he just used, you could use that the entire game and easily win. Well, people, you used to be able to. They nerfed it, right?
Comet Azure?
Yeah.
Oh, you can still, like, if you Comet Azure and the blue flask that gives you unlimited, and then, like, you know, Terra Magica, which boosts sorceries, like, you can still get through a lot of the game with just Comet Azure, yes. I mean, it's a great spell. There's Gideon. Boom. I went back to Cragblade for Gideon, because I like Cragblade better than Flame of the Red Mains. So we're gonna hang out here for a little bit longer. We will. Oh no! Do 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 do. What do we want here? Maybe some. No, just fucking health. Just health. That's what we want, right? That's what we want. All right, we're doing great, everybody. we're doing fucking great. Yep, we got that. Ashes of War, we got that. Great. We are on our way, everybody. Let's see if we can take out. Let's see if we can take out. Where? Oh, fuck. Where are we? Where are we? What are we doing? Let's see what we can do with Horaloo. Oh, Horaloo would be another good one to go, Youper. Oh, so you're the new Tarnished, eh? Nice to meet ya. Nice to meet ya. Listen here, I respect what you're doing here, and I always say, like, hey, you know, you don't spit on my fence, I don't spit on yours. But that being said here, I think I gotta stop ya. I think I just gotta be the one to stop ya.
Get off my tree.
That's all I'm saying. It's like, you know, like, I'm happy that you're here with my tree, but I think our disagreement is coming to a head. You know what I'm saying?
Are you gonna take on Melina in the stream or
God no?
No,
she's the worst. If how about this? If I am able to beat the Elden Beast and we have time left, we will try to make our way to Melina. Okay. The answer is going to be no, though, because I don't even know if we can get through Elden Beast. I don't even know if we can get through Horaloo. I don't know if we can do anything.
Well, we do have a last stream to look back to where you said the Elden Beast would be a pushover.
I did not say Elden Beast would be a pushover. I believe my exact words were, I don't think I will have a problem with the Elden Beast.
Yeah, apples, oranges, same thing. Right?
Right? God damn it. God damn it, Horaloo.
Why is he called Horaloo?
That's his name.
Oh. This is Godfrey First Elden Lord.
Well, listen, did you play the game?
I did. It's been a while.
So,
I haven't played the same game for the entire year.
Touche. While he is Godfrey, the first Elden Lord, before that, he was the warrior known as Hor'a'lu. And so you fight him as both. Do you remember his phase two where he just goes full, like, wrestler?
Yeah, yeah. Oh, yeah, yeah. Right.
That's when he goes... Oh, there we go. That's when he goes full Hor'a'lu. And so he was, like, a vicious warrior and, like, you know, a person of strength and renown, which is why Merica chose him to be, you know, the first of the Elden Lords. Mm-hmm. And that's the reason why the lion is on his back. The lion is on his back actually to quench his bloodlust. But after we're able to get him to phase two, he rips the lion off and he returns to Hor'a'lu, first of the tarnished.
Yep, I remember that. Telling Baratheon, redeemed their message, says, I felt that God know in my soul, Jack. Hard agree.
You know... I have beat her exactly once when I needed to because I wanted the Age of Stars ending and I had accidentally got the three fingers. I got three fingered and the only way to get un-three fingered is to go through her storyline. I had to once and I want to say that was during like the weird. Like, that was during, there was a series of patches where there was, like, an easy cheese for her, and they fixed the easy cheese, but then they made her significantly more difficult, especially mm-hmm. if you were calling in helpers, and then they made her easy again, and then they made her more difficult. So I beat her during one of the more difficult phases. It took me and two summons just absolutely trying our gosh darn best.
Lampy asks, what happened to Marty today? Did he do the soy sauce challenge again? Marty is busy with a sponsorship campaign that we're working on. And then because we are reinvesting in the website, he's going to be doing more writing again. So he may step back from a couple of the streams he's doing to make sure that he has time to do all the other stuff. We're pretty excited about the website. We're starting to put big plans together.
Dang it, Hor'a'lu, let me hit you. Yeah, here, fight my jars for a second.
Marty does too many streams. He enjoys doing them. That's why he did so many of them. Right, Frost. We can finally do clickbait articles. Been waiting all my life to do that.
We just need more. We just need like three more clickbait articles. That's all we want to do.
Yeah. Some, you know, every title going forward will have someone, and that seems to work out really well. I don't know if you've seen all that, Jack.
What?
we have thousands of gamers angry at us because we wrote a title that someone made Doom work in Notepad instead of directly tagging the creator, even though he's fully credited in the article. And he made a joke about it. A joke, and he wasn't mad about it or anything.
Yeah.
But oh boy, the people on Twitter are very angry at us for not giving credit to the guy, even though we did.
Ah, gotcha. because you didn't specifically give credit in the title of the article.
Yes. Because guess what? Welcome to journalism. You need people to click on your story.
People are
and
the worst.
And someone is the hook of the story.
Yes.
Because people look at it and say, who did that?
I wonder who. I would love to find out.
To learn more. Yeah.
What was those? I remember back in the day you shared like the actual numbers. There was one of Darren's articles, you know, got picked up by trolls and everyone was upset at him. And it was like what was that number breakdown again? I always forget, but it's one of my favorite anecdotes to tell people about how many people actually read the article.
Oh, yeah. Like, I think on Twitter it had like 100,000 impressions, but 5,000 people clicked on it.
Amazing.
Yeah.
Amazing that like 100,000 people are like, oh, man, this article sucks. But so then what's the, is that 5%? 100,000, 5,000. Yeah, that's five. So like
5%. Less than 5%.
Less than 5% Reddit, and it's like, oh.
Yeah. So the justification for why everybody was mad at us today was that because we're on Twitter, the headline should have the whole story on it because they're not going to click on the article anyways.
That's dumb. So then why write articles?
Well, they're like, we don't want to give the escapist ad revenue by clicking on the article. And I'm like, you're literally getting the news from our Twitter feed on Twitter, giving Twitter ad revenue.
We don't like, want to give these, but they, so they just hate us is what you're saying.
Yeah, they just, yes, pretty much.
It's
so dumb. So,
that's what I say.
It's yeah. It was kind of amazing, like the amount of people that are like, yeah, you should do the work for us, but we're not gonna click on the article anyway.
Right.
All right.
Ay.
Being in media is fun, people. Because you do your job correctly and people still get mad at you.
Okay. Come on.
It's just funny because like I like using the escapist Twitter account, just the brand account, stresses me out beyond belief because like I'm just like I don't like we could post like dog saves grandma from wildfire and people would still get mad about it for some reason because we didn't give the dog's name.
Or the grandma's apparently.
Yeah, or the grandma's name. Probably even more mad about the dog, but I love being a student of journalism, but man, every person on the internet thinks they are also a student in journalism. Lampy highlighted message says so many listicles now. Hey, Marty wants to do lists because we think we can have lists can be fun. I like doing lists. Lists are fun as long as we make it interesting. Talon Baratheon highlighted the message says that reminds me of a tweet that sparked a lot of outrage discussion in the comments, but the link was broken, so it was impossible for any of these people to have read the article itself.
Just the title.
Yeah, that's literally what happens every time.
Right. It's amazing.
Yeah. So I mean, thankfully, like. Nobody went after, like a couple people went after John and me directly, I think, but like nothing too bad. Everybody's just yelling at the brand account. Mm. So no direct harassment, but you know, every time that happens, you do get people that like quote tweet you to yell at you. You block them and they're like, yay, I got blocked by a check mark. I'm so cool. And I'm like, if that's your achievement in life, I'm sorry.
You know, some people aim low, Nick.
They really do. if you're proud of getting blocked by somebody on Twitter.
You know, low expectations.
Hey, all right. Mom, this journalist blocked me on Twitter today. Are you proud of me?
I did it. They put it on a job application where they're like, well,
not got blocked to, Nick Landry on Twitter.
Not to brag, and he's a blue check mark, and he blocked me. So, you know, you're welcome, I guess.
Storm Templar says, have you just thought about ignoring the trolls? Sometimes you can't when that shit's just blowing up on your phone at a random. You're like, what's happening?
And here's the thing. Like, there's a time to ignore. And there is a time to talk about it. And the as someone who has dealt with a ton of incredible shit from the internet, it is not always the time to ignore. And like in with people in general, like not on the internet. Hey, come here. What are you? Do I want you?
Mm-hmm. Yeah, to be fair, I didn't even respond to anybody. I responded to one and said, hey, we credited him three times in the article. Here's where it is. It was all there at publishing, so this is incorrect anyway.
Yeah.
Well, they still didn't like that because then it was like, oh my God, you're getting defensive. I'm like, okay, I give up. I'm not doing this tonight.
I feel like for anyone. Oh no, did I mess up the Nefeli Lu quest? Oh, I might have.
But, yeah, I don't know. Sometimes, like, yeah, I definitely as a social media manager, you got to pick your battles sometimes. So, best thing you can do in that situation is clarify that, clarify the narrative the best you can that we did credit him, because people are too dumb to read anyway. And if people don't accept that and start saying you're being a baby and a bad social media manager and all that other bullshit, well, then there's nothing you can do there. They're just going to go and be mad.
Right. No, and think about real life as well. Is sometimes the appropriate response is to ignore people, and sometimes the appropriate response is to confront them and to make sure that, your side is being heard and they are being exposed for how awful they are. And so you do hear that a lot, though, of you should just ignore them. And that's not always true. That's all I can say.
Sometimes you gotta defend it, because otherwise people just run with the narrative and then it never goes away.
Exactly. And for the immense amount of shit that people on the internet get, it's naive to think that it can all be solved by just ignoring all the assholes.
Mm-hmm. What was even sadder about it is the developer felt bad and apologized to John directly, and then was in the Twitter thread, that everybody was yelling at us. I was like, guys, you're defending me for nothing.
Mm-hmm.
They credited me, and then they all ignored that, and there's still people tweeting at it mad. I've got it muted, but I just am keeping an eye on it to make sure, because there were some nut jobs in there, and I'm making sure there's no threats coming towards anybody.
Right.
Always my fear. I'd rather everybody be mad at me than go after people on the team. So,
dealing with internet trolls is like dealing with actual babies. Just let them scream until they tire themselves out, unless something is actually wrong. Well, and that's the thing. That's the thing is when something is actually wrong, you have to deal with the screaming, and it's deciding when it's an actual thing, which is why it's a tricky situation. And I do agree that sometimes ignoring is the best thing to do.
If people are just mad because of an opinion, I always ignore that, but if somebody's calling our credibility of actually crediting somebody, that's where I'm now you're questioning the whole credibility of the outlet, and that's gaining traction, so I need to stop on
yeah
that.
Yeah, exactly. So it's just about judgment calls. That's all it ever is. It's about judgment calls. Oh, I think I fucked up the Nefeli quest line by killing what's his face?
The true Mandalorian puts in quotations, "I'm a student of making bad choices and drowning in debt. Click here to learn what kind of choices in debt." Debt may shock you. That's clickbait. And the debt is just normal college debt.
Beautiful. That's
great. I love what clickbait has literally been turned into anything that makes you actually interested in clicking on an article.
Right.
And not oh my God, you won't believe what I found in this box. First line of the story. It was a pair of shoes.
Yes.
Holy shit.
Bait implies a hook at the end. Bait implies something bad happening after the bait. Like there being nothing in the article. You think it's food, but it's actually bait. That's what bait is. Did I mess up Nefeli? Hold on.
Lampy Idiot highlighted a message over on Twitch, says, "Much like babies, please don't take internet trolls on airplanes or to movie theaters."
Now we're talking. Gosh darn it.
They shouldn't be allowed on the internet.
I fucked up. What I was hoping was that I could continue Nefeli Lu's quest line, because if you continue her quest line, she can show up to help you with the Horalu fight, as she apparently is a direct descendant of Horalu. But technically speaking, we are also a descendant of Horalu, as all Tarnished are descendant from Horalu.
It seems I have gotten Martin with the clickbait and wants to know what type of shoes. They were just New Balance, basic white-ass shoes that a dad would wear.
Basic,
really stunning.
basic white ass shoes. I love it.
You know what? You know what brand of shoes has reinvented itself though to be like more modern?
What's that?
Skechers.
They've always been pretty modern.
I don't know. I've seen my dad wear Skechers and it was like goofy.
You might be thinking of New Balance. New Balance is the
No. New Balance. I know New Balance. New Balance is like literally.
That's the dad shoe.
Yeah, the cookout barbecue dad shoe.
Yeah. Oh fuck. All right, Horlu. Let's settle down, Horlu. Here, fight my jars for a second. Fight my jars, please. Thank you. You.
Jason Tudors is a former shoe store manager. Skechers are absolutely prime boomer.
Prime boomer?
Boomer prime.
Nice.
They have like nice boat shoes that are super comfy to wear and good with them. Teacher Carr says you leave my gray and blue New Balance alone. Yeah, I guess I shouldn't make too much fun of New Balance. I forget I'm one of the younger people engaging with the escapists these days.
You're a young.
Yep. You're right, Storm Templar. Jack is a dad. I don't see Jack wearing a New Balance shoe though.
Yeah, I have New Balance.
Oh, okay. Well,
I don't wear them. Those aren't my everyday shoes. But one,
wear them with your cargo shorts.
First of all, I don't wear cargo shorts. Ew. Like, and
wait. That's not true. Because on the Escapist show, I remember specifically an episode that you were very excited about a pair of cargo shorts you had.
No, I am anti cargo shorts. It's very difficult to find shorts nowadays that aren't cargo shorts. So you might be remembering opposite of me saying like cargo shorts suck. I hate cargo shorts because the only thing you can find is cargo shorts.
Oh, maybe it's a pair of longer jeans you had then that had extra pockets that you were excited about.
Like I have a fanny pack and I have New Balance.
So you just need a sun hat.
I have a sun hat because I'm bald. And guess what? If you
not the sun hat. What they don't even, I don't even see people wearing them anymore. They're like the half hats.
Oh, like a visor.
Visor, yeah. It's your visor. Lampy 88 says nobody wants to engage with the young people. Nick, most of them have no money. I don't know about that. I just saw like a video on social media from TwitchCon where this dude was hosting. The streamer is hosting a party, and either I guess the cover to get in was for people to buy like 50 subs for them, and some kid bought 25 subs to get in, and like got kicked him out for.
What? Because
it wasn't enough money. Yeah.
That's weird.
Streamer culture is very weird. I'm glad our audience knows that when Yahtzee guilts people for money, they know he's just being an asshole and trying to be funny. He's not being serious. Same with the rest of us. Like,
right?
Never expect you to give us money.
Nobody wants to. Oh, huh.
I'm most sorry, enthusiast. Donate $5.
I'm still on cargo shorts, all right? That's where I am.
PF Flyers for when you want to run faster and jump higher. The only shoe worthwhile.
Isn't a PF Flyer a wagon?
Don't know.
Yeah, like I have kind of like my everyday going out shoes. They're from a company called Enda. Very
PF Flyers. Those are everybody knows those. I don't know those.
Yeah, that's fair. They're very, very comfy shoes. They're very good shoes. They're made from by an Ethiopian company. I do have some New Balance shoes. Like if I'm if I'm going for a walk, like if I'm specifically like going for like an exercise walk, my New Balance are very nice. But I have wide feet. So.
Yeah, my dad and I have very flat feet. So. Sometimes I have to wear slippers around my house on the wood floor because it fucking hurts.
Oh, wow.
Yeah. Apparently, wood floors are very bad for your feet.
Oh, sure. Well,
and like it will inflame the tendons in your feet.
Oh, we're not doing anything? We're waiting until I make a move?
Did the Keanu Reeves come get it? Is this a $200 cover fee for parties in that much? That's what 50 subs cost. Well, the guy showed the receipt. He paid $257 and he still got kicked out. So, yeah, I don't know. Maybe it's 50 tier 3 subs or something. Which would be like $500, right? Stupid. I would never pay that amount when I go to somebody's party. So you don't walk on the wood floor as you slide. Well, yeah, see, I already fell on the stairs, so I'm not looking to fall on the wood floor again. Although my stairs are carpeted, so. $400 for tier 3. Crazy. Also, the guy that was hosting the party, like, took one look at his Twitter feed. He is the most cringiest person I've ever seen on Twitter. Sure.
That seems like a big title.
Yeah.
I've seen a lot of cringe on Twitter.
Yeah, this is like one of those like really entitled asshole people that is like, I have a lot of money and I want everybody to know it.
Ah, gotcha.
And I really don't like those people.
All right, we got to phase 2.
Oh, it's $800 for 52 3 subs. Yeah, I don't know. Maybe it's tier 2, tier 3. I don't care. Either way. No. and yeah, still Clay Gamer, you are right. A streamer did break her spine, or break her back in 2 places at TwitchCon.
Oh, yeah, I heard about that. There was some sort of, like, foam pit?
Yeah, it's like one of those, you know, like, dueling foam pits where you have, like, the big foam wand things and you hit each other with them.
Yeah.
Yeah, she jumped into the foam pit and they didn't cover the floor enough, so she literally just landed straight on concrete. And broke her back in 2 places.
Oh, that was the closest one we got so far. I made a choice. I broke his stance, and then I used the stance break to heal, and then I tried to get in there for a quick like 1-2 pot shot, and that was a mistake, because then I was too busy swinging and not busy reacting. Their foam pit wasn't thick enough.
Yeah, like they, on the it was just on a convention center floor, which is usually concrete.
Ooh, well.
And so, like, they only had 2 feet worth of foam. So she did like a straight up dive bomb into. It's a good thing she didn't go with her head first.
I was gonna say either she signed a liability waiver or they're about to.
No,
get
they're getting
sued.
They're getting sued. They're getting sued hard. There's no way.
Ah, she could have signed something.
Considering they weren't smart enough to put more foam on the ground, I'm assuming no. They had to sign a waiver. Yeah, I don't think the waiver would have said, though, that you have a great chance of breaking your spine in a foam pit.
Yeah, you know, then now it depends.
Maybe getting hit in the face with the foam thing, like if any injury happens, like, yeah, but...
Yeah, it just depends on what they... So now it's up to the TwitchCon, right? To be like, how are we going to deal with this to make sure she doesn't sue?
Well, that's what I meant. Well, either way, she's getting a big payout because the PR, like, she's it was Jason Tudor gave the name. I'm gonna mispronounce it probably, but Angelina Chechik. She's very popular, and that was seen by everybody on social media. So, like, if they want to save any PR, they better take care of her medical bills.
Oh yeah, at least.
Apparently, and it also, yeah, like, apparently multiple people got hurt at TwitchCon. Like, some girl, I think, also dislocated her knee in that thing.
Oh, my.
Yeah, so, like, I mean, like, multiple people got hurt, and they didn't close it down and fix it.
Sure.
So, you know, somebody said in chat, negligence. Yeah. Not impressed me with a lot of their decision makings in the last couple years. They're making YouTube look very good lately.
Doing a great job, Jars. Doing a great job. Did a great. Oh, okay. My Jars did a better job than I did, is the moral of the story.
Yeah. We may stream, but I don't particularly like streamer culture. Very very self-centered. I also went down a rabbit hole, because that's what happens when you're a journalist and just start looking into stuff. And I got linked to an episode of Dr. Phil.
Okay.
Where he had two, I think, streamers on there.
Okay.
And these guys were so... Either they were just trolling, or they legitimately believe this, but, like, one of them was literally like, yeah, I don't talk to my family because they're irrelevant because I have more followers than they do. And Dr. Phil just looked at him like, huh? And he was like, what? And then, like, the kid took the pot shot at the audience too, like, yeah, everybody in the audience is irrelevant too, and Dr. Phil just... like, straight face says, well, I didn't know about you till today, so. if you want an interview to cringe so hard at, I mean, it's like my face, like, literally turned inwards.
Yeah, but, you know, like, situations like that, too, where it's just like, oh, well, that's exactly, like, what Dr. Phil wants.
Yeah. Oh, yeah, he wants it on there, but still even hearing somebody say that, I was like, oh, my God.
Well, it's like, that's what Dr. Phil wants. It's even possible that kid was coached to say that to make for good TV, because all reality shows are, you know, scripted and terrible. And so it's like,
Shark Tank's amazing.
Who knows what what the truth of that situation is?
I don't know if it matters. You still put yourself out on live TV saying something like that. You're not going to not look like the victim. Or not a victim. You're not going to look like not an asshole.
Oh, yeah. Nope, 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 nope. Damn it. Stance break. I thought three was the stance break, Horalu. I thought it was three. I thought we were going for three. Jack has woke on reality TV. I had a friend of mine who was on...
You're woke on reality TV?
I understand the reality of reality TV, which is that it's 100% scripted all the time. Like even Shark Tank, I'm sure. Like, they get coached on what to say. People, contestants get coached on what to say. Like, they edit it to make it more dramatic. They, like, quite literally have scripts. I know many people who have been involved in the production of reality TV. I know people who have been on reality TV. It's one, every single one is 100% fake.
Yeah. That's why, like, yeah, I could never, ever watch, like, stuff like The Bachelor.
Right. It's manufactured. Come here.
That and also the I just find the people on those shows so utterly shallow that it makes me feel uncomfortable that people are that like
fair
devoid of any depth of a person. Their entire personality is centered around money and fame. And also couldn't like literally have to go on a show to make a human connection with somebody.
Right.
This is dystopian as shit to me.
Yes, that's fair.
And I think that's why people like us, because we don't do that shit. We have real conversations about how I got drunk when I thought I was losing my job and fell down my stairs. So next stream goal for Nick to go on The Bachelor. I would just be sitting there laughing at everybody. I could never take that seriously. Like, being put in a line and judged with a rose? Like, no.
What is going on? Why am I... There we go. I was just not breaking this man's stance. Alright, Jars. No, my Jars. Don't you want to fight my Jars? Don't you want to fight my Jars? My Jars look like they could put up a really good fight, a really worthy fight.
Nelson thinks this is a wait, Nick is getting fired. No, I'm not getting fired. When we learned about the sale of Escapist, it was a surprise. Never, we didn't hear anything, so the first thing I thought, as like all enthusiasts cared about, was numbers. It was like, oh man, we're all gonna get laid off and they're just selling zero punctuation. Because like they did not, e.g. to the minute they sold us, did not understand our business model at all, even though I explained it to them every week. So I was like, well, fuck, I just bought a house and I'm not gonna have a job now. And also there's like probably no way I'm getting another job in games media. So I didn't go out with the intention of getting drunk over that. I just happened to have a top shelf. I did the mistake of beer before liquor, never sicker. And had a top shelf tequila shot. That didn't go well.
I mean, tequila in general, always a bad idea. Tequila shots, yeah. I mean.
And then the falling down the stairs was just an unfortunate accident of missing a step in the dark. It just didn't help that I was drunk. I think it's just funnier that I was drunk.
You know, we all have different standards of comedy.
Yeah, I would not do well in a comedy club.
Okay. Oh, wow. I biffed hard right away.
So, but yeah, not last week, but two weeks ago was very, 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 very stressful for me.
That's understandable. It was a weird time.
Yeah. Well, and if anybody follows me on Twitter when I tweeted out the Batman, so that's what that feels like. It's because I found out we were being sold on Twitter. I was like, oh, this must be what it feels like to learn you're possibly getting laid off from a Twitter post before you're told.
Right.
So I don't know. Yeah.
Ooh, all right. Oh, by the way, how was the did the poll? Did people think I was going to beat Malekith?
It's the 45% said yes.
Oh, okay.
18% said no.
Uh-huh.
But also 38% said lol.
Yeah.
So if you combine the 38 and 18, I think more people thought you were not going to do it.
Fair.
So they basically pulled a Google Stadium. Yeah, kind of. I mean, it worked out for the better because nobody got laid off, and we're with the parent company now that's only focused on media and not esports and NFT and crypto and all that bullshit. So. Every meeting I've had with them has been good. I'm excited. optimistic. And we have a very unique business model that they don't have, and so we have a lot of opportunity ahead of us.
Yay! Oh, fuck.
And yes, companies don't tell their employees things like that because they don't want you to ruin the deal. So. Yeah. Oh, I have plenty of stories to say. I'm not gonna put it on Twitter right now, but my favorite thing was like 3 weeks ago. It was like right when we did the year 3 update video on the channel. We had the Eve documentary trailers ready, and I shared the Eve documentary trailer with our general channel on our work Slack for enthusiasts, and multiple people that are at the top of the company were like, "We have a documentary crew?" And I literally looked at the computer, I turned it off, I went out and got lunch, and I was like, okay, I'm done today.
Yep.
I was like, you have to be kidding me. This is crazy. I have never felt like, I felt very defeated, I felt insulted, and then I was like, you know what, I'm just hungry, I don't want to do this right now.
I just like that, like, Jarls, no! Jarls, you've got this. Oh.
And Jarls is dead.
And Jarls is dead. It's like, first phase, I'm getting, basically, right now I'm limping through first phase. And technically, he has kind of, three phase. He has, first phase, phase and a half, and then second phase.
Mm-hmm.
And I'm limping through first phase, even a harsher limping through phase and a half, and second phase is just destroying me. So we gotta find something to do here. Come on, do something. Come on, do something.
Yeah. You know, when they said that we have a documentary crew,
yeah,
I thought about putting that as my Twitter bio for a bit. Speakeasy at the previous parent company? No, I don't think they knew we existed. it was not great. I can tell you, I was not happy there. So much camera jumping.
Oh, I thought that was me breaking his stance. Oh, fuck. It was not. Spoiler alert.
But, yeah. So if any of you are wondering why we pushed so hard on subscriptions, because, that's what kept us, that's probably what helped us be sold. Because, we are in a sustainable model now.
Yeah, which is very nice. And in the few conversations I've had with our new parent company, they're always like, oh, yeah, you guys you're doing your own thing. That's really nice.
Yep.
You bring in money. Woohoo. Yep.
It's like, wow, a media group that actually knows how to make money?
Whoa. Right.
See, they're completely on the same wavelength as me. It's like, it wasn't me that said, or it wasn't them that said they don't want us to rely on them. It was me that straight up said, I do not want to rely on you guys as a parent company.
Right.
I want to make sure that we can self-sustain ourselves, and then you guys that are there to invest and support us and make sure we get paid. And they're like, yes, we like that. We like to hear that. I was like, okay, cool. Because we know what we're doing. We don't need to be told what to do.
One. Oh, did that not hit? Oh, is that my problem? One. Two. And and three. Okay, it's three flame of the red mains that breaks his stance.
like how his weapon catches on fire, but it actually doesn't do anything.
Nope. Oh, fuck. I gotta remember that stupid foot stomp thing. I think I jumped during that. I forget.
I think you can roll towards it.
I
think if you try to roll away, it gets you because you're like you're rolling into it as the animation's completing.
I think you're right. It's something. I have zero thoughts on. I have the same thoughts on the Super Mario movie that I had before the trailer, which was like, yeah. Could be fun. Illumination has quite possibly the worst track record, as the only thing worse than Minions is Rabbids. So I don't necessarily trust the animation company to make a good movie. It looks cute. I don't, you know, Chris Pratt has a nothing voice. I think I prefer literally any voice to the original Mario voice actor for an entire feature-length film. I don't want to hear that voice. I don't want to hear, aha, woohoo, hee-hee, for an hour and a half. Yeah, I don't want to hear that one. Chris Pratt doesn't, like, have a... Chris Pratt was cast in the Lego movie because he has a perfectly average voice. That was the character for the Lego movie. Hey, we need average man. That's Chris Pratt. And so it's like, I have no strong feelings towards him as a voice. And the movie's like, let's just remember who's making the movie, right? Let's remember that it's Minions. And Minions sucks. So, it's the same as it ever was, as far as I'm concerned.
I just want a fun movie. I could care less about the voice. Novarisa asks, Nick, would you ever consider starting your own company down the road? It seems like you have a good handle on financing and finding talented staff. Financing is really hard. Maybe, I mean, I might be in a better position now to do something like that. But, I mean, I did sell both of my original websites to Enthusiast Gaming, which it ended up becoming technically mine again under Escapist because they were both folded into it. So, I don't know. We aren't, you know, aside from Yachts and all that, we are not the biggest talent in the world. Like, I don't think it'd be kind of hard. It'd be very hard to convince everybody that like going independent is the right call.
Yeah, that can get real tricky.
Yeah, I mean, you know, if I had. You know, a very successful YouTube channel of my own and all that, and maybe go on my own, but I like working in this environment. Well, I should say, I hope I did not like working in the last one. No, as long as you have a company behind you kind of supporting and investing in what you're doing, like, that's the best of both worlds, where, you know, they mostly leave you alone to be independent, and all the people that run gamers seem to actually have come from media backgrounds, so I'm a hell of a lot more confident that they know what they're doing. And the fact that like, they actually listen to me when I talk to them and don't sit on their phone.
Like I do?
The former COO of Enthusiast Gaming was literally in a meeting giving a... update on, he asked me for an update on our operations, and in the middle of me talking, pulled out his phone and started talking to somebody.
Oh, fuck, I rolled. No, I'm dead. Horaloo. More like horror poo poo.
Snake in the Garden donates 2 euros, says donation for the Jimmy Gems for moral support.
Thank you. I appreciate that. I appreciate that. This is now, you know, it's tough. It's just a tough game.
You all right, so you said if you didn't beat Malakath, your run was going to end.
Yeah.
If you don't beat this guy, is your run still ending?
This is the real tough, because now there's only, you know...
Him, two bosses after him.
Technically, there's only two bosses left. There's him and you know, the final boss. So it's like, that might not be enough for a stream. Also, it would be a very boring stream, as it would be like me... smacking my head against a brick wall for 2 hours. So that's a...
I don't know. If they put up with me fighting Ishin for like 4 hours in one stream, I think you're okay. Although, if you want, you can go get another sound machine. If it really makes you feel better, you can smash it again.
That would not make me feel better.
Make me feel better. Thanks, Damian Glenn, for the reminder about couldn't care less, because I will never care more than less.
Oh, what?
I don't know. that's one of those phrases that I feel like everybody gets wrong. And I just couldn't care less about.
What's up after this stream series, and could be something other than Elden Ring for a bit. And we were talking about doing Bloodborne, maybe.
Yeah, we could, like, and really, well, like, we could just do a Bloodborne playthrough. Like, it doesn't even need to be a special. I could just play Bloodborne, because, fuck, I could play Bloodborne anytime. And starting in November, we're going to start Willow Month, and we're going to play Willow.
I do want to say, I really want to see you take on a Souls game that you haven't played.
Not if Souls like. Yeah, exactly.
Souls like. You know, no, because a lot of them are really bad.
have you tried Neo?
Yeah. Yeah, we did a previously recorded on Neo.
You didn't like it.
The stance switching mechanic was so convoluted.
Yes, there is a lot of mechanics in the game.
You fuck.
He still needs to play through Bloodborne, but has scheduling issues that
fuck.
Have yet to be resolved. Yeah, he's doing hidden gems and he's got God of War now. So make sure you tune in on Wednesdays to see him play God of War.
So yeah, like, you know, we'll either do a Bloodborne. Yeah, maybe this is it because we're just winding down. We need to wind down. My SpongeBob tarnished pants is pretty ridiculous. In general,
Now Lampy wants you to play something other than a Souls.
Oh, like no Souls in general. You know, we'll see.
What's another game that you? What's another game? Challenger on now. Is one
right? It needs to be a game with a heavy RPG aspect, because that's where the different things come in. And so it's like, you know, Skyrim has different challenge runs that can be fun.
Oh yeah, they did want you to play Breath of the Wild with Marty.
Oh, I fucking love Breath of the Wild.
That's not really like a RPG mechanic heavy game,
right? What the fuck? Right, but like I could just play that. Like I said. We know November. What's the calendar? Hold on. Let me get a calendar.
Well, if you really like Bloodborne, you might try Thymisa. Thymisa. I don't know how to say it.
Oh, that's the one with the clockwork bullshit.
Clockwork?
No, what's that one? What's one am I thinking of?
It's a Souls game.
It's a Souls game.
It's a very fast paced Souls-y game.
Sure. Okay. So what we need to figure out. So. How long do you think it'll take to play through Willow? Because we need to figure out the next 2 weeks. What are we going to play for 2 weeks? Then we have October 31st, Monday.
You can be Willow in 6 hours.
Oh, okay. That's first of all, that's bullshit, right? Or did you actually look it up?
No, I looked it up.
Oh, okay, great.
How long to beat?
Oh, okay, great. So
you're bullshit.
I am bullshit. We need something for the next 2 weeks, maybe 3 weeks, even though like the third week is October 31st. And you know, it's on Halloween, so we should do something spooky. If it's
I was gonna say you've never played Dead Space, and we talked about doing that last year, but KC recently did a full Dead Space playthrough,
right.
Want to see that again.
We need something short for like an October, or we just add that to the list. Oh wait, oh I know something. I gotta figure out how long it is though.
What?
I know something we can do that would be very silly.
What is?
Have you been following? There's an insane person who has decided to make the Waterworld adventure game that was featured for a minute on The Simpsons.
Waterworld? No idea.
All right.
What's it called?
I think it's called Waterworld Adventure Game. I don't know. What?
I said oh. Waterworld. Is it on Steam?
No. Oh, God, no.
Oh, itch?
Yeah, this is going to be like a nothing's officially licensed kind of deal.
Kevin Costner's Waterworld? Is that what it is? Oh, yeah. It's an arcade game.
Yeah. It was an arcade game that was featured as a joke in an episode of The Simpsons. So this person made their best...
Made the fake video game. Yeah.
Made their best attempt at making the actual video game that was a throwaway joke in an episode of The Simpsons. That's been on my playlist if we want to play that for next week. Oh, well, listen, when Liza P comes out, you know I'm playing Liza P. Fucking Pinocchio Bloodborne?
The Souls game that you were thinking of with the clockwork was Steel Rising.
Ah.
And yes, you would not like that one. But
correct.
I think if you wanted a new Souls, the Detroit, I think Amnesia is up your alley.
We'll see. We'll see. Basically, what we're saying is starting next week, we'll play something. Why doesn't that hit you?
And you don't like side-scrolling Souls-y games, do you?
That's not necessarily true.
There's Moon Scars.
Back. Nope, I'm dead. I'm dead already. There's what?
There's a new one called Moon Scars that came out.
Moon Scars. Okay.
Yeah, it's a bit more action-heavy.
Okay. Great.
Yeah.
Great. Well, listen, next week we're going to play next week we're going to play Kevin Costner's Waterworld.
Okay.
Cuz that's funny. And I just really want to play it. I want an excuse to play it.
Probably make sure it can go for 2 hours cuz I highly doubt it goes for 2 hours.
That's an important caveat to put. That is a very
like
very
a 15 minute game.
Right.
Because I would just watch a video on it and they finished it in 20 minutes.
Okay. So, then I got to come up with a plan B. Which, you know, we can do.
Baldur's Gate check.
Baldur's Gate.
Too slow for him.
Jack hates a lot of things.
Jack does hate a lot of
things.
That's
the important thing
to remember. We learned about this on the Escapist show.
That's the important thing to remember.
Every time I mention the game, Jack's like, ugh.
Jack has taste. Jack has specific taste.
Yeah.
Not just taste. Yeah, a lot of people have taste. Everybody has their own taste. I have a very particular taste, and I'm very picky.
Time for you to try Death Stranding.
We've talked about Death Stranding. I've gotten very far in Death Stranding, and I love so much of Death Stranding and think that so much of Death Stranding is also very bad. Death Stranding is an incredibly fascinating and interesting game that absolutely shits the bed.
You can also try Code Vein, the anime slicing game.
I'm good.
Yeah. That was a very quick, I'm good. No thanks.
Jack played Baldur's Gate 3 on Stadia.
Actually,
that might be true. I don't know.
Did you ever try Darksiders 2?
Darksiders 2.
No. You would know if you did.
Would I, though?
Yes. Because you really like Zelda-esque games. You would probably really like Darksiders 2.
Yeah, I have no recollection of that video game.
Okay.
I have no recollection of that video game.
And then, as your editor and overlord... I'm going to have you try it, because I think you'll like it.
Oh, okay. Uh-oh, Tulok, Raid of Mikala. No! Hello, every... You. Huh?
Somebody's raiding you?
My good, good internet friend, Tulok the Barbarian, who also streams Elden Ring, and we sometimes stream at the same time. I appreciate you all being here.
Now there's pressure on you to actually win this fight.
Oh no, I'm failing.
You gotta impress them.
I'm failing so bad, everyone, that this is gonna be the last time I stream Elden Ring in quite some time. That's how bad I am failing at Elden Ring. Why does that not hit? That only hits sometimes. It's so upsetting. But I appreciate you all being here. I am a big fan of Tulok in general. His videos are always wonderful. He doesn't do challenge runs. He makes character builds in Elden Ring.
Mm-hmm.
And so, like, you know, he did, like, a be Wolverine, be Batman sort of builds in Elden Ring. And they're always funny and always interesting. He did a really great Sans from Undertale build in which he did not... upgrade his vigor once, and so he had to basically get through the entire game without being hit once. And it was
no.
What a beautiful video. Also, no.
Yeah,
that's why I like the videos because I'm not. Gonna
yeah, I'm not gonna do that. Yeah.
But watching someone else do it has been great.
Just like the anger that would come from getting that one hit.
Yeah.
Like, I spent 40 hours on this to have it over.
Three. Get out of my way, jar. If these dumb jars could do a little more damage, I feel like we would be doing a lot better. Yes, I am blaming my jars. Oh, I got him in two that time. Now my jars are going to get in my way, making rolling harder.
Let's see.
Excuse you, I drank that. Oh fuck.
There's another fine. Boss that just does not care about your jars.
No boss cares about my jars because they are the worst summon. And that's okay. Like, I understand that they are just the worst summon.
I'm going to be giving you the biggest tip of the day. Maybe you should try not getting hit.
Thanks, Lampy.
Yep.
I was feeling really good about that run up until we got to phase 1.5. Jack used to be a big fan of Overwatch. Will he try Overwatch 2? No, I'm good. I've seen some footage. Yes, I played a ton of Overwatch. Really enjoyed Overwatch. And Overwatch 2, from what I have seen, seems a lot like Overwatch 1, plus a ton of microtransactions and season passes. And it looks like the same game, but with more ways to give Blizzard money. So I'm good. I don't need to.
Way to stand by your morals.
What morals?
Exactly. I don't know.
Yeah, I just, you know, it looks like something that will be a reasonable amount of fun, but also suck money out of everyone who tries to play it. And that's not necessarily what I am looking for in video games. Now, I could be wrong. I have not played it. So, you know, the possibility of me being wrong definitely exists.
I'm just waiting now for somebody to ask if you're going to go back to Team Fortress 2.
I have. I've gone back.
Another question's coming back.
I've gone back to Team Fortress 2 a few times, and you know what? It's pretty fun. Here and there.
Rocket League is my new addiction right now.
Rocket League's the best.
I wanna get back to my Siege, but just my friends are making me play Phasmophobia every night right now, so.
I legitimately would. I did it. Okay, good. Like, Phantasmophobia seems like a game that I would enjoy, like I said, but.
Phasmophobia.
That one.
Yeah.
You know, that game.
All right, what's your butt, though?
We already talked about that, which was, like, the act of getting people together whom I enjoy playing with would be such a hassle. And I already deal with that with board game night, with D&D night.
Like, I see. You don't want to play with me or Jesse or KC or Frost.
No, I'm sure
I have some team that would play with you.
But then we have to schedule that, and it's that, like, the act of scheduling becomes so much of a hassle that then you can't enjoy the game. You know, I'm sure I would love to play with all of you, but then it's like, oh, can't do that day. You can't do that day. Frost can't do that day. You know, no. Right?
Pretty free during the week. You're the busy guy.
Yeah. Well, we all have different schedules.
Yeah, I think you're just making excuses now.
Sure.
I've been playing video games every night, so. And yes, Storm Taffler, he did call it Phantasmophobia.
FOMO.
Donates $10, says, hi Jack, great stream, and I hope you have been well. Donating for the Adventures Night Challenge, as it is my favorite escapist content. Everyone out there, have a lovely day. You too, Aston Food.
Oh no. Mistake.
Yes, we are playing it on the 22nd. Might be. I don't know if Jack is going to be there. I told him about it.
Did you?
Yes.
That sounds like something you would do.
I did it on live stream too.
Oh well, that
was proof.
If you tell me something on live stream, you know I'm not remembering that.
You don't remember it if I tell you on stream or off stream. It doesn't matter.
You have to like. Say it, and you have to like make me put it in my calendar. That's
just gonna, I'm gonna write it backwards on your forehead,
right?
So
that's
you
how
look in the mirror, you
I
see
need
it.
To remember it. All right, we're gonna give this one more try, and then I'm deleting Elden Ring from my computer. we're just gonna take a nice, long, deserved Elden Ring break. We're just gonna look at
you
the
will have it. You will have it re-downloaded by next week,
probably. Like, let's be honest.
Exactly.
Listen, my SpongeBob Tarnished Pants build is pretty funny, is all I'm going to say. I should have just switched to that an hour in and showed you SpongeBob Tarnished Pants because it was pretty funny.
Just put it in his calendar? He doesn't check his calendar.
Nick doesn't have access to my calendar?
I don't have access. Yeah, you're right. You don't have... you? Did we get you an escapist email?
No.
Oh.
I never had an escapist contract.
Well, you know, most people didn't, so.
Right?
Hell, when they sent over my contract to gamers, I was still listed as managing editor of video from 4 years ago.
Oh, okay.
So.
Oh, all right. Well, here ends. Here we go.
Oh, you just got pounded to end the stroll.
Oh, here we go. Let's get into a nice... There we go. Here ends the tale of Jarls Barkley.
He failed.
Who failed to become Elden Lord, who, much like his older cousin Alexander, just wanted to be part of the great fight, and sometimes that means you get shattered. So do not weep for Jarls Barkley, for... He lived for the fight, and sometimes that means you live to lose. Cupcake Edge, member for 5 months for early access, says, Jack, I got my dad to join my D&D game. That's great. Like, it's such an amazing game. My home group is getting together next week for the first time in a couple months because of scheduling shenanigans. We just haven't had the time. And so, like, we're getting together to see if we can remember enough of the campaign to keep going or whether we're starting a new campaign. But I am terribly... And, of course, we haven't been filming Adventure Is Nigh, which is my, like, other regular D&D session.
Yeah.
And so, like, I am itching so bad to get into some D&D. I'm terribly excited. I'm so happy that your dad joined you. Get more people involved. It's so great. It's so great. It's the best.
Now you got to get him to watch Adventures Nigh.
Goohoo! Like my kid has a club at school now. Like there's a D&D club at school. It's like
It's gone really mainstream the past few years. Like everybody's I know is getting into it too.
Right? It's great.
People that I don't even expect to play D&D.
You know what? It's collaborative storytelling. It's improv and math. You can't ask for anything more. But thanks, everyone, for coming to this stream. We will see what we will do next week. We're going to take a little Elden Ring break so I can recalibrate my thumbs and Jarls can have a well-deserved rest. So thanks and bye, everyone. And
we have multiple more things coming up this week.
Oh, shit.
In 30 minutes, come on back for Hidden Gems with Casey and Jesse.
Yeah.
They are playing Paradigm, I think is how you say it.
Sure.
It's some weird, very weird looking point and click adventure game. If you go look at the thumbnail and you aren't confused by that, I salute you for that. Tomorrow is Tuesday, which means Darren. Marty and I will be back for the recap to discuss Werewolf at Night.
Ooh,
and then I'll be back.
Yes, Werewolf at Night.
3 p.m. to do more Neo on the Editor's Hour. I think we're moving into like Mission 6 or 7 now.
Cool.
Making good progress on that. Of course, CP and post-CP on Wednesday with Breakout in the evening. And then after that now, the God of War stream. So Wednesdays are stacked. And then Thursday, I'll be back to start Jedi Outcast, which also, I don't know if you guys saw, but on the website, Jedi Outcast just got a VR mod for Quest.
Ooh,
so I like, rebuilt the whole game in VR, and it looks really cool. I might give that a try, because using a lightsaber in VR is a lot of fun. And there's also severing of clone troopers' arms and legs. So,
also, if anyone needs to know what the best adult dating site is, I got a hot tip for you.
Where's that from? Oh, is it the chat?
The YouTube chat. The porn bots came right at the end of the stream. The porn bots came. If anyone needs to know what the best adult dating site is, we got that going for us.
Heck yeah. And then, Friday, more Metal Gear Solid 4 on Thursday. And then Friday, Amy and I will be back to do more Grounded. Jack and Marty and J-Mate will be playing something.
Mm-hmm. Saturday is Adventures Nigh side quest episode 1 for everyone. Become a member now. Become a YouTube member. Become a Patreon supporter if you want to watch that episode now. It is so darn fun, and the 3 episode run of the side quest is a gem. Is an absolute gem of a series. So all that fun stuff coming up.
That's it.
That's it.
Thanks everybody.
Hey, bye. Goodbye.
Bye, Jarls.
Goodbye, Jarls. You.
He looks very sad.
You will be retired, not forgotten, and not deleted. I won't delete you.
This kind of looks like a fat version of the Stanley Cup.
Oh.